But the president refuses to take his call.
President Johnson is a busy man.
Too busy to talk to his oldest ally. Historically, the holder of this office has the warmest relationship with Downing Street. Think of Churchill and Roosevelt, or Truman and Attlee, Macmillan and JFK.
No need to keep mentioning Jack Kennedy like that.
Keep mentioning.
It's just provocative. Unhelpful. President Johnson is his own man.
Of course. I mentioned it only in the context of our leaders standing shoulder to shoulder in times of difficulty. The United Kingdom and the United States. Historically, it's like a marriage. Will you talk to him?
No, screw the Brits. I don't like them. I never liked them. They're not looking down at you through their noses. They're holding their hands out like beggars. And I don't give a crap about any special relationship. Harold Wilson wants my help. You should have thought about that when he refused to support me over Vietnam. You can't screw a man in the ass and then expect him to buy you flowers.
The Prime Minister, Your Majesty.
Your Majesty.
Prime Minister.
I'm sure that it did not escape your attention that President Johnson failed to attend Sir Winston's funeral.
Yes, on account of a cold.
Well, that was the explanation the White House gave, but it persuaded no one. I fear that the President may have taken against me for what he sees as my failure to support him over Vietnam. And I wondered... In the past, the royal family has been extremely helpful in keeping this special relationship afloat. And given the predicament the country finds itself in economically...
You'd like us to roll out the red carpet, make a bit of a fuss?
Please.
All right. I shall consult the three wise men, see what they have to say.
Thank you, ma'am.